Yo.
What up? All right. We got another one from Def Comedy Jam.
Okay. What we got?
This is Michael Collier.
Michael Collier.
Yes.
All right, man. Funny dude. Yeah. So this is Def Comedy Jam. This is some classic stuff right here.
Yes, Michael Collier. Classic. He looks very, very young.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
And
man.
Usually, like, I've seen him like in like he was like in like the Parkers and on seen him on Martin.
Yeah.
You know those type of shows back then.
Exactly.
But he was older then. So I mean, this looks like it was like 20, 30 years ago or some shit. It looks totally different. Yeah,
it's totally different.
It's gonna be like interesting.
In the cut screen, looks like an undercover doctor, man. You know what I'm saying? Let's go, man. I'm ready, man. All
right, here we go.
Wait, shit. I'm mad. I'm gonna start right now. What I'm pissed off about. I'm pissed off about the Rodney King business. The latest thing about the shit that bothers me that now the police want to get off. They say they shouldn't have to go to trial because they didn't get a speedy trial. They've been violated. Let me tell you what pissed me off. Number one, you don't treat humans like that. But secondly, this will really fuck me up. They lied on Rodney King. They said Rodney King was doing 117 miles an hour in a fucking Hyundai. Wait a minute. When the fuck you ever seen anybody doing 100 miles an hour in a Hyundai? Let me say this. If you out driving on the freeway and you see somebody go zipping by at 100 miles an hour in a fucking Hyundai, I suggest you get your ass off that freeway. Have a nap because you are fucked up. The only way you can do 100 miles an hour in a Hyundai is if you're going down a steep hill full of fat people with a heavy tail wheel. That shit don't happen. Something, and this is not a racist statement, but only white folks were shocked when they saw that tape. Police whooping black folks in the black community ain't no new shit. When I saw that, I thought it was a fucking new Timex commercial. I didn't know what the fuck it was. Shit, I called my man. I said, God damn, how come I wasn't up for that? Who is Rodney King? Why is he getting all the damn work? That's what I want to know. And any black man watch that and still driving, you're brave. You're goddamn brave. I'm scared to drive. I bought a fucking bus pass. I'm scared to drive. If I look in the rearview mirror and see the police coming, I start worrying about shit I did back in sixth grade. I don't know. I'm going to say this, man. Last week, the police made me get out of the car, scared the shit out of me. I said, get out of the car. I said, what I do, officer? I said, well, you're doing 15 and a 20. 15 and a 20. Yeah, you're going too goddamn slow. So I jumped out the car, grabbed a blackjack, and started whipping myself. Just whipping myself. See, that way you cut out the fucking middleman. See what I'm saying?
You know.
Hey, real quick, let me just do a quick check. How many people here do crack besides me? Smoke crack? Raise your hand. One, just one, two.
What the hell?
Smoke crack. I don't smoke that shit no more used to. Anybody used to? Be honest. Come on, you lying motherfuckers. Be honest. Get them hands up. Shit, I did crack. That's why I talk about this shit, because I'd never do it again, but I did a lot. Not a little bit. I did a lot of crack. I did so much fucking crack, one day I broke in my own fucking house. You hear me? I was halfway out the door with the TV before I realized it was my fucking place. I didn't know. I fucked up. I was springing. They call it sprung. I was springing. You know what sprung is? Sprung when you turn your life over to crack. You do anything for people. Wait, I'm sorry. You do anything for a piece of crack. You jump through a glass window if you thought that white. No, wait a minute. I'm sorry. If you thought that white speck in the shag rug was a piece of crack. And when you on crack, everything small and white look like crack to you. Small piece of paper, small piece of lip, small white poodle. You think it's crack? And then people say, Michael, how you stay so slim and trim? Shit, I don't mind telling you. Crack diet. Crack diet, Gary. You want to lose some weight, man? Fuck Jenny Craig. You want to lose some weight? Start smoking crack. You will lose weight two ways. Number one, you lose weight because when you smoke crack, you automatically lose your appetite. But secondly, this way you really lose the weight is running back and forth to the pawn shop to sell your shit. One last slice I do want to talk about. Anybody here fucking besides me? Anybody else? All right, we do have some fuckers in the house. Good, because I got
to talk to you about safe sex for 1 second. A lot of people didn't raise their hand, but I really believe that everybody in this audience is either fucking or know somebody that is. All I'm talking about right now is protecting the ding-a-ling. Now, there's only two ways to do this. One way is a sure way. We call that abstinence. That's right, abstinence. That means completely give up sex. Okay, fuck that, yeah. Second way makes a lot more sense, and that is the proper use of a condom. But most people can't even pronounce the word condom. I ain't bullshit. One guy told me it was a condom. One guy said condrone. Of course, my favorite word for it is a condominium. The people say, what about you, Mike? What about you? Damn it. Do you practice what you preach, safe sex? Do you utilize a condom each and every time you have sex? Hell yeah. Shit, I'm wearing one right now. I'm out of here. I'm gone. Bye.
What the hell? What the hell?
Tripping. Oh man, yeah, man.
Nigga said, how many people do crack? How many people do crack?
Me, I don't used to do crack. Oh man, yeah.
Damn.
These maybe 3-4 people.
Yeah.
But yeah, man.
Shit, nigga said a crack diet.
Yeah.
Really? Shit. Somebody, honestly, if you was like morbidly obese, like, you might want to go on some crack.
Really?
Get on some crack. I don't know.
You think that would help?
It might kill them instantly, but... but, you know, if they can find a way to survive, they might lose some weight over time. That shit might... They might go into shock.
I still think if you're morbidly obese, you have to move. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
You just sit in one spot and do crack and lose weight.
You know... They just don't eat. If you don't eat,
yeah.
But yeah, I think they just like legalized everything in one state. I forgot what state it was.
What?
They legalized every drug. They legalized methamphetamines. They legalized crack. They legalized marijuana. I think marijuana was already legal in this state. I forgot what state. I'm dead serious. And this just happened.
Oregon?
I think it is Oregon.
Yeah. Some things got, they're the ones that got like police free zones and shit. You know what I'm saying?
I think they just legalized crack.
Interesting. Interesting. Well, I wonder if that's going to be like, you know, they said like after like, you know, Colorado legalized weed and places like that, like, you know, homeless rate went up and stuff like that. Huh, that's interesting.
The homeless rate went up after they legalized weed?
Yeah.
What are they saying? States.
Huh?
What are they saying?
What do you mean?
What does that mean?
It means that homeless people are moving to those places. They're going to.
That weed is legal?
Yeah. So now that everything is legal.
The fuck is going on? That's just scary. It's like The Walking Dead, some zombies or some shit. I'm like, it's going to where the weed's legal.
What the fuck?
Going to Oregon. The fuck? Fucking homeless people care where they smoke weed at. Like, you're smoking weed outside anyway. You're going to be outside no matter where the fuck you at. Police ain't fucking with you. You smoking weed? They fucking with you because you loitering.
If it's Oregon, then they got police free, and you can do any drugs you want to do there.
If you're homeless, you can do any drugs you want to do anywhere.
What stipulation? It's cold as fuck in Oregon.
Yeah, why do you want to go to Oregon? I'd rather go to California and do drugs. Oh my god. Weed free zone in Oregon.
Drug free zone in Oregon.
Drug free.
But no, it should be like, I think they should embrace it like Canada if they're going to do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, have
Canada's
places.
Gonna do it?
No, not like that, but like they have places where people can go and do drugs, like, you know what I'm saying, that are addicted to hard drugs. They can go there and do them like under the observation of,
like, where?
Nurses and shit. Like in Canada, they got that shit.
Like hospitals?
Yeah, it's like some type of clinic. I don't know what
it is. So if you're like, I'm going to do some crack, you'd be like, I'm going to go to this hospital and check in and do some crack for a night and then check out the next day?
Yeah, I think it's something like that, yeah.
That's weird.
Yeah, but at least they're supervised. I mean, They're getting free crack?
Do they have to pay for this?
And it's weird because I think they give them, like, I think they have, like, bowls and needles and stuff like that. Like, if you want to inject and stuff like that. Because you're using clean shit. You're not using, you know, you're not spreading
diseases
and shit like that. I mean, I'm just saying, if they legalize every drug and organ, like, if that's it they did, then they need definitely have something like that in place. Definitely. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, that's bananas. That's bananas. But hey! Hey, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I think is it Colorado? I think they legalized shrooms.
Oh, mushrooms?
Bro. Yeah, I think so. I think. I don't know. I could be wrong.
I've never done shrooms. I heard that they take you on a trip.
Yeah, man.
It's like that, like, trip.
Yeah, they're on a trip, man.
Like DMT. DMT, yeah. You see, like, these beings, I've heard.
I think it's cool, like, shapes, patterns, or stuff like that, like, totally cool, but, like, something I could possibly touch or fight or want to fight, or, like, that's just too intense, I think. You know what I'm saying? Too intense realization, like a hallucination.
You're supposed to come to some realization once you take DMT, like, you get a sense of why the fuck we're actually here.
Interesting.
I might take that shit like when I'm 80 years old.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do that shit now.
Yeah, get
stuck. Fucking my whole. Oh,
I saw the future.
Yeah. Fuck me up. Nigga, just stop doing everything.